Yeah, he deserves a big hand. He's worked his tail off around here, I'll tell you that. And the guys with Mojo Sound, you guys are doing a heck of a job, and we appreciate you. And I also want to thank my folks and all my family for coming. I was a member of a group called the Bluegrass Little Bits back in the 70s, and along with Larry Jackson was the first lead singer. And he was part of a Southern Express, which is performed here today with my brother-in-law, Ron Rimmer. So, I mean, I'm just surrounded with family and friends and a lot of memories. I used to run around here as a child and chase the little girls all over the campground. had a good time. Yeah, I did. And my buddy Chris is up from Jacksonville or down, so we thank y'all for coming. And I'd like to do a song for you folks right now that it's a title cut of our new CD, and it's a song that was inspired by a gentleman that came up to me at a concert we did at a church in Illinois. And we had just got through performing the song, we did it earlier today, called Mama Prayed and Daddy Plowed. And this fellow, I'd say he was probably in his mid-80s, and he came up to me and explained to me that that song, which talks about growing up in the farm life and seeing your parents, your dad working out in the fields behind a mule and a plow, and that sort of thing, you know. And he said that that was his life. He said the words of that song was his life being transformed, you know, in song. And he, as he's telling me this, a tear started rolling down his cheek. And he told me, he said, there's something that his mother had told him growing up. She said, son, if you're going to eat in this world, you're going to have to learn to dig in the dirt. And that little phrase, dig in the dirt, stuck in my head. And I could not stop thinking about it for about 2 weeks. It just kept spinning around in my head. And then one day I picked up my guitar, and the words just started coming just as fast as I could write them down. This song was probably written in about 15 minutes. And it actually made it to number 2 on the national countdown on the Bluegrass charts about a month ago. So we're real proud of that. And we're going to do it for you now. It's one called Dig in the Dirt. As I watched my daddy working out in the fields, we prayed for rain so we could pay the bills. He said a wise man better learn as he goes. Life's a mighty long road to hoe. We were up with the chickens and we worked till dark. Mama used to tell me, gotta do my part. By the sweat of my brow, row after row, made a man out of me as I watched it grow. You got to be dig in the dirt.
Well, this is a duet that Tim and I recorded, but I always think about Mama when I sing this song, and for the obvious reasons, and you're liable to too, but I love to tell this. When I was a kid, I was raised up by probably the meanest mama in the state of Tennessee. I ain't kidding, 4'11", 90 pounds of mean, that's what I thought when I was a kid. She would do things that the other mothers didn't all do. She'd do things like, she'd make me do chores. Oh, yeah, I don't mean like make your bed kind of chores. I mean like go chop the wood chores. You know, we had wood heat. Somebody had to split the wood, you know. Make me do my homework. Oh, and then she would check it to make sure it was right. More than once, she got me back out of bed to correct homework that I had done and done incorrectly. Now, who does that? You know? Made me go to church. You didn't get up at my house when I was a kid and ask, are we going to church today? You just knew. You couldn't even lie and get out of it. I tried one time. I said, "Mama, I can't go today. I'm sick." She said, "Really? You're sick? Throw up for me." Yeah. Well, which is a trick. Because if you can't throw up, you ain't sick. And if you can throw up, she'll say, "Now, don't you feel better? Let's go to church, you know? You're going to go either way, you know?" No, I tell you what, I just love her to death. Daddy passed away last year, but Mama's going strong. And, you know, but I think most of us, when we look back, most of us along the way had a mama, a grandmama, an aunt, a sister, a teacher. You know, there's a lady or ladies along the way that seemed like they was always the ones that would, you know, that call you on it if it was necessary. You know, they'd tell you the truth and nobody else would. And, you know, and I realize now we're a whole lot better people because these ladies invested in us. And so we want to sing a song for the mamas. In fact, the meanest mama in Florida may be right here this evening. So we'll sing it for you. We hope you enjoy it.
The heavenly stairs and medals for mothers were given up there. They mentioned a million things Mom did for me, things I took for granted and never could see. If there's medals for mothers, for all of the deeds they have done, if there's medals for mothers, are you with and kind of love and care, a medal for beauty she won up above. But the biggest of all was a one for her love. If there's medals for mothers, for all of they have done, if there's medals for mothers, Mama, you win every war. Mama, you win every war. Yeah.
Thank you so very much. Let me get Don over here and do a little banjo picking for you. Don sings the bass for us in the quartets, great banjo player, and award-winning, and worked with a lot of the major artists. But you know, he mentioned earlier about Don's kind of dry sense of humor, and somebody asked him, was that true? I said, well, I tell you what, you just have to be around him to know. We were out, it's been a couple months ago now, and we'd been out for several days, and Keith got a text message from his wife. And it was one of those real sweet, you know, I love you and I miss you, you know, hurry home kind of thing. And, you know, Tim and I, we romantic guys. We was trying to give him some suggestions and some things to write back that would be equally sweet, you know, that sort of thing. Don said over, didn't say a thing. But finally, Don said, text her back, who is this? Yeah, Keith didn't. He's still married. He didn't follow that, but we laughed. I tell you, he's just so much fun. Going to do a little banjo picking. This is a Tennessee boy, one of the finest in the business. Make hand for Don Hill on the banjo right here.